The sun rises over the ooze washes. Another day begins. As the temperature rises, insects become active, not only on land, but in the water as well. If you look closely, colourful insects can be found in the undergrowth. Close to water, damselflies and dragonflies start to emerge. Banded damozel warms its wings in the sun. Damselflies and dragonflies are expert hunters and catch flies on the wing. This red damselfly has landed to eat a recently caught fly. Flying insects should beware, they too are hunted. An intricate spider's web makes an ideal trap for flying insects. This damselfly won't see the end of the summer. Nor will this unfortunate bee. For those insects that survive the start of the summer, their thoughts turn to the next generation. There can be a lot of competition to find an ideal mate. At the height of summer, butterflies add a burst of colour to the ooze washes. Like this colourful tortoiseshell butterfly. As soon as the temperature is warm enough, small lizards come out of hiding to warm themselves up in the sun. The ooze washes, with its rivers, lakes and ditches, is an ideal habitat for grass snakes. Grass snakes are elusive reptiles and can be hard to find. This grass snake is basking in the warm, shallow water. Grass snakes are excellent swimmers, spending most of their time hunting near water. Grass snakes prey mainly on amphibians, especially the common toad and the common frog. Rivers on the ooze washes in summer can be busy. This grey heron shares this part of the river with a cormorant. Boats pass close by but don't seem to disturb the heron. Herons don't always have peace and quiet. This heron is being buzzed by common terns. Eventually, the heron has had enough and flies off. This grebe family are enjoying the summer sunshine. Meanwhile, back on the riverbank, a flock of grey-legged geese are feeding. This young greyleg has left the flock and come down to the river for a drink. Crystal clear water provides glimpses of fish. An ideal place for a kingfisher to hunt. It's a busy time for adult swallows feeding their young. This nest is on the Lock Keeper's cottage at Denver Lock. Further south, at the WWT Reserve at Welney, swallows have made their nests in a couple of hides. This chick is reluctant to leave the safety of the hide. At the northern end of the Ouse Washes lies the Denver Lock Complex. A flock of Egyptian geese have made their home here. Egyptian geese were introduced as an ornamental wildfowl species. After escaping, they are successfully breeding in the wild. The Ouse Washes isn't just for wildlife. In the summer, you can fish from fishing platforms or take a walk in the beautiful countryside. You never know who will join you for a picnic on the riverbank. Boat owners have lazy days on the river. At the WWT Reserve at Welney, there is a walk that is only open in the summer. You can also have a stroll to one of the many hides. There may be summer visitors to see. At Denver Lock, there is a weather station that records rainfall, humidity, and other readings, including wind speed. With the vast open spaces, it can get very windy on the Ouse Washes. It looks like summer rain is on the way. The rain clears and the sun comes out again. Nuts and berries are starting to appear, a sure sign that summer is coming to an end. This female brown hawker dragonfly has found a sheltered place to lay her eggs. Back at Welney, work is underway to prepare the reserve for winter. In the early evening, lizards climb up fence posts to catch the last heat from the sun. This lizard has survived the summer. It has lost its tail to a predator, and a new tail can be clearly seen growing. It won't be long before this grass snake is looking for a place to hibernate for the winter. The sun sets on another summer in the Ouse Washes.